Welcome to Arrow News Channel. Like and subscribe to update news around the world. Trump just made outspoken victim regret everything he said after making sudden shock announcement. Almost 2 weeks after the deadly shooting in Florida, we are no closer to implementing the answer to the problem of school shootings than we were on the day that it happened. Both sides of the political spectrum feel that they've got the answer to end school violence, but without a meeting of the minds, none of those answers will be put into place. The one thing that we know for sure is that in the case of this shooting, the system broke down. There are people who should have stepped in that didn't, and, thankfully, people who didn't have to step in that did. This poses a very personal question that many of us have been asking: would we have done what it takes to stand up for the innocent? This question has been circulating because of the now infamous security guard that didn't rush in when danger came calling, and at least one student who both blames and attempts to exonerate him. Hopefully, each of us would have the selflessness to run into the fray if children's lives were at stake, and that's just the standard that President Trump wants to hold those in charge of our students to. The Hill reports that he addressed this issue while talking with various governors on Monday. President Trump on Monday claimed he would have run into a Florida high school to prevent a gunman from carrying out this month's mass shooting. "You don't know until you test it, but I really believe I'd run in there even if I didn't have a weapon," Trump told the gathering of governors at the White House. "And I think most of the people in this room would have done that, too." The president was doubling down on his criticism of an armed sheriff's deputy who did not confront the shooter at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School, where 17 people were killed earlier this month. "They weren't exactly Medal of Honor winners, all right?" Trump said. "The way they performed was frankly disgusting." Trump also told the governors he ate lunch last weekend with leaders of the National Rifle Association, NRA. "Don't worry about the NRA," Trump told the governors. "They're on our side." The president is looking for a way to make sure that the problem is solved by at least putting individuals in place to protect our young people who would be willing to put their lives on the line. One of the reasons for that is because teenagers have notoriously bad judgment, and it has to be expected. Somehow, though, the media keeps going back to these understandably traumatized teens, trying to get adult-sized answers out of kid-sized people. Even if they have the best of intentions, they're young, inexperienced, and probably a little shaken up. Case in point, the poster child for this particular senior class and son of an FBI agent, David Hogg. He's done numerous interviews, given confusing statements, and generally gotten a lot of screen time. Whether his comments are from the heart or being fed to him by someone else, very frustrating at best. He's now blaming the governor of Florida for the security guard that didn't rush in to help his classmates. He even laughably said that his movement would outlive the NRA. Breitbart News reports that he made those confusing comments on MSNBC's Morning Joe. Monday on MSNBC's Morning Joe, Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School senior David Hogg said Governor Rick Scott, RFL, should be held responsible for the Broward County Sheriff Department's actions leading up to and during the Parkland school shooting. Hogg said, "I am glad you bring that up. It is raising concern the fact they didn't go up, but that brings up two things. One, how can we expect our teachers to step in and take action if trained security guards part of the sheriff's department wouldn't take action? And two, why are these elected officials trying to blame this on the bureaucracy? They're in charge of them. This is their fault. They should have been regulating them. I am not going to allow them to pressure these people, because at the end of the day it is their fault. These elected officials are the boss of this sheriff personnel, and just like the president is the boss of the FBI, Governor Rick Scott is essentially the boss of Scott Israel the sheriff, and as such he should be held accountable and can't blame this on the bureaucracy and expect to get re-elected." He added, "I want to point something out, that football coach was a security guard and he was protecting those students. He is one of the people that stepped in, unlike those cowardly Broward County sheriff's officials. Honestly, I fully support law enforcement and we always should. Without them, I wouldn't be able to speak here today. None of us would. We wouldn't have a functioning democracy where everybody can practice their First Amendment right to freedom of speech. Sadly, these are a few individuals did not conduct their job correctly, but I don't think it as right that Governor Rick Scott is blaming this on the bureaucracy in an effort to get re-elected. The fact of the matter is that we are each responsible for our own actions. As elected officials, there is more that can be done by some in a professional capacity than others, and they should strive to do it. However, there is nothing more telling when it comes to a moral check than whether you will put yourself in harm's way for someone else. Greater love hath no man, and apparently that security guard was no man. It is time to address the difference between the good and the bad and get the good into the places of power.